Krish, the good news if you're a British tourist in Paris tonight is that the value of sterling jumped higher after Angela Merkel in Germany suggested that a solution to the Northern Irish border problem could be found by October the 31st. The bad news is that it is as clear as mud how that solution is going to be found until Boris Johnson provides more details and convinces his European partners. Yes, it's true, we did hear Emmanuel Macron use the word amend the agreement tonight, but it wasn't entirely clear what he meant. And the problem seems pretty much as intractable and insurmountable as it did at the beginning of the week after 2 days of talks, first in Berlin and today in Paris, with Macron also saying that he regarded the Irish backstop as indispensable. In the grounds of the Petit Palais in Paris, a statue of Winston Churchill, repeating his victory march down the Champs-Élysées and his famous battle cry, "We shall never surrender." And at the Elysee Palace this afternoon, his devotee, biographer and successor, Boris Johnson, still in search of victory himself, still demanding the end of the Northern Irish backstop, but giving ground of sorts by coming here after almost 1 month as Prime Minister.
And I want to make it absolutely clear to you, Emmanuel, to the French people, that of course I want a deal. And I think we can get a deal, and a good deal. I was powerfully encouraged by our conversations last night in Berlin with our mutual friends. And I know that with energy and with creativity and application, we can find a way forward for all our businesses and our citizens.
Emmanuel Macron sported a holiday suntan. The Prime Minister doesn't have time for a holiday and has ordered his senior advisers to postpone theirs. And his host offered him precious little sign of compromise, because the backstop, he said, was indispensable.
I want to be very clear. In the month ahead, we will not find a new withdrawal agreement that deviates far from the original. I would like to say that the key elements of this agreement, including the Irish backstop, are not just technical constraints or legal quibbling, but indeed genuine, indispensable guarantees to preserve stability in Ireland, to preserve the integrity of the single market.
Let's work.
Amid the back slapping, the backstop seemed as big a hurdle as it ever was. The French president said he endorsed Angela Merkel's suggestion last night that Johnson come up with a better idea in 30 days. But then the German chancellor said she hadn't meant a literal deadline of 30 days at all, on a day in which everybody seemed to be talking lots but saying very little and barely moving the debate forward.
I said that what one can achieve in 3 or 2 years can also be achieved in 30 days. Better said, one can also achieve it by October the 31st. So it's not about the 30 days. It was a symbolic way of saying that it's possible to achieve it in a short period of time.
The pound jumped higher on Merkel's optimism.
Mr. Barrow, are you meeting with Mr. Barnier today?
And Tim Barrow, the UK's permanent representative to the EU, was seen entering a building in Brussels a few minutes before Michel Barnier, the EU's chief negotiator. But it still felt as if a solution to the impasse hadn't really moved any closer.
The no deal will never be the choice of the EU, never.
Mr. Johnson's approach.
And though the chemistry here in Paris was much warmer than this bitter dispute might suggest, perhaps this was bargaining for the sake of being seen to bargain, in advance of more recrimination to come and the avoidance of blame. This was never going to be a meeting of minds, but when you strip away the uncompromising rhetoric on both sides, the question remains the same. Will the relentless advance of time, the fear on all sides about the economic consequences of a no-deal Brexit, and the return of MPs to Westminster next month mean that somehow a no deal will be avoided by October the 31st. From the 34th floor of this insurance firm overlooking the French capital, an economist rates the chances of a no deal Brexit at 40%. So why is she optimistic? Because she thinks MPs will block no deal, that the UK will step back from the economic brink, and that at the 11th hour, the political shadow boxing will stop.
In my view, it's just a technique of negotiation. The Europeans are tough, the UK is tough, so they need to get into the negotiations further before they compromise. So for the moment, it's too early to compromise. In my view, we are going towards a very last minute deal, probably in the second half of October, where we will get another extension. Should this extension of Article 50 come with general elections, with a new referendum, we don't know. But what we know is there needs to be a reason for this extension. The Europeans have clearly said that they would not agree for another extension without any clear objective. And an objective could be a general election.
But Boris Johnson has said do or die by October the 31st, attempting to strengthen his bargaining hand by warning that Westminster cannot intervene, even as French and European officials are still clinging to the idea as to a life raft from a sinking ship. Jonathan Rugman, Channel 4 News, Paris.
Well, earlier I spoke to Nathalie Loiseau, the former French Europe minister, and I began by asking her whether Mr Macron is saying the withdrawal agreement could be changed.
If he has a magical wand, and if he can manage in a few days' time to find a better solution, we will look at it. But we have been working on it for more than 2 years, and the best we could find was the backstop.
But you are saying it is possible that if he comes up with some great idea that none of us have thought of yet, that the withdrawal agreement could be changed.
I would very much like to have him come into details and concrete proposals, because until now, the letter he wrote to Donald Tusk was obviously vague, and I don't think that there was something more precise in his conversations with the German Chancellor or the French President.
But isn't the logic of your position that in sticking to your agreement that has failed to pass the British House of Commons, you are going to guarantee a failure of that open border?
Well, you are talking about us, but it's a British decision. If there has not been a majority in the Commons for the backstop, it's precisely because of Boris Johnson and his friends. They have made a choice to make it more difficult.
Yeah, but it affects you too.
I'm sorry, but consistency of our market is as important as sovereignty of the UK. And no hard border and peace on Ireland is a common objective, both from the UK and from the European Union. And I have not heard one single British national coming with a better idea.
But what I'm saying is that if we have a no-deal Brexit, we will be on an inevitable road towards having some sort of border infrastructure in Ireland.
This is why a no-deal Brexit is a madness. Well, of course it's madness. It's pure madness, but that's your choice.
But you also have a choice here, which is to look at something that isn't as bad as that.
No, I'm sorry. A bad deal is even worse than a no-deal. For the interests of European citizens and for the interests of European companies. And this is obviously what we have in mind. And believe me, a withdrawal agreement without a backstop or something guaranteeing integrity of the market and security and stability in Ireland would have no majority in the European Parliament where I sit.
What will be the impact of no-deal Brexit on France?
Well, we don't like a no deal, but we are prepared for it. When I was a member of the government, I passed 5 bills in order to be ready for a no deal. We won't like it, but we will survive it pretty easily.
Will there be an economic shock in France as well?
It would be a slowing down of relations with the United Kingdom, but with the United Kingdom only.
Each European country will be facing an economic shock. Is that not something you want to avoid?
Yes, but
so why won't you compromise?
We have compromised already. The backstop is a compromise. My question is, how do you consider that you could reach a deal without compromising? And for the time being, Boris Johnson is simply painting clouds in pink and saying that Brexit should only be a piece of cake because this is what he sold to the British public. But this is not true. Brexit comes with consequences, and negative ones. Of course, he never said so when he campaigned for the referendum. But this was misinformation, and I'm very sorry about it, and feel very sorry for the British public.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you for your time.
My pleasure.